What's up, guys? I'm Salty Mike, and this is your Star Citizen Week in Review for April 15th, 2024. We went to Wave 1 for 323, but man, I don't think it's ready. I'm really starting to get hyped for some economy changes, though, and we are going to at least hear about cargo soon. All that and more on today's Week in Review. And as always, if this is your first Week in Review, this is where I take all of the official Star Citizen news each week, put it into one video, and share some of my opinions about it. I also live stream on Twitch, twitch.tv/saltymike. And thanks for all the love from you guys coming over from here on YouTube and hanging out. I appreciate it. Now, we're going to need some magic for 323 to get ready soon. And with that, I would like to share with you today's sponsor. Thank you to Magic Spoon for sponsoring today's video. Growing up, I ate cereal every morning and sugar pack cereal because it was so convenient before school. I really need that convenience now with my early morning schedule, but I need higher quality, higher in protein, and I don't want any artificial ingredients. Magic Spoon has my mornings covered. It fits a variety of lifestyles. It's high in protein, keto friendly, gluten free, grain free, soy free, wheat free, and it's naturally flavored. Magic Spoon cereal has 0 grams of sugar, 13 to 14 grams of protein, 4 to 5 grams of net carbs, and it's 140 calories per serving. Magic Spoon treats, they got 1 gram of sugar, 11 to 12 grams of protein, and 1 to 2 grams of net carbs in each serving with 130 calories per serving, and they're high in fiber. Click the link below to get some Magic Spoon cereal today. You can build your very own custom box with all the flavors you love and use my code SALTYMIKE for $5 off. You can choose from the best-selling cocoa, fruity, frosted, peanut butter, and maple waffle flavors. Fruity is my favorite. Plus, other awesome flavors that include honey nut, blueberry muffin, birthday cake, cinnamon roll, and chocolate chip cookie. You can also add any of their delicious cereal treats to your order. Magic Spoon is so confident in their product, it's backed with a 100% happiness guarantee. So if you don't like it for any reason, they'll refund your money, no questions asked. So click the link below or scan the QR code and use code SALTYMIKE for $5 off, or go to magicspoon.com/saltymike and save $5 off your order today. Also, for my Canadian and British fans, Magic Spoon ships to Canada and the UK. So get in there, click that link below, and enjoy some Magic Spoon today. And thanks, guys, as always, for engaging with the sponsor spots. They are paramount to some of the changes we've been kind of making here on the channel, like the professional editing of these videos. But without further ado, let's get to the patch notes updates. All right, and there's a bit to get through, and we start out with Monday. Monday was an EVO Kati patch, and they did a lot of updates to the AI, and they were punishing, let me tell you. And they're sort of making the star map more readable as well, emphasis on sort of. And they added a lot more ammo to the Ares series of ships, not just the Ion or the Inferno. A lot of people were scared that the ship would kind of fall out of the meta completely, and it doesn't look like that's going to be the case. Then we moved on to Wednesday, which started out in EVO Kati. Big change here is that AI pilots used to be able to shoot forever and never run out of ammo. Now they can. I think they're really trying to leverage us in the PU to make Squadron 42 AI fun, and I'm all for it. I think if you play Pirate Swarm and you've played Wing Commander before, you can kind of see the comparison, and it does remind me a bit of that. This, again, was an EVO, and they were testing engineering, and then it randomly went Wave 1 while we were testing it, and it was a bit of fun. I think it needed a lot of work as well, and I have an hour-long video posted here on the channel of that unedited experience if you want to see it. Then Thursday, we're still tweaking the AI, and the big thing for me is they're balancing the very strong shotguns just a bit. And anyone who played Gunrush, I think, would be okay with that. I can imagine everybody had a very high KD with the R97. Friday, in terms of updates, there wasn't that much here for the like PU changes that you were expecting, and I think they're just scratching the surface here on the impact of reputation and things like that. This is a huge piece of the puzzle for Star Citizen, and we're just getting the beginning of it now. Now, the big thing here is that they were testing the proper Xeno threat mission, and I had a really hard time playing this patch, as every time I tried to log in, it was incredibly, incredibly unstable. But they did try to push a hotfix and other things like that to get this thing working. Master modes. There is so much here, actually, that I'm going to make a dedicated video on the channel, or at least try to explain it a little bit more. So get subscribed if you're interested in that. And then, yes, I'm sorry I didn't have any footage for Xeno. And yeah, it was extremely difficult to get in and play this. And I'm not going to lie, I'm starting to get really nervous, not just about the state of the game currently, but the longevity of the enjoyment of 323. I think a lot of people looked at the cards in 323 and expect to be able to play that all the way to the next patch. And yeah, we have issues with general stability. And for me personally, this is just a personal feeling, the things that I was looking forward to most, all the updates around cargo and hangars do not exist at this time. Let me know what you guys are feeling. Are you feeling as nervous as I am? Because I'm starting to freak out. Then we got a new launcher, and this thing is pretty cool. It's more useful than the old one. Just to note, if you use a different drive than C, make sure you update where you keep your download directory. It's in beta, and you can keep the old launcher in case there's any issues with this one. Then there was Overdrive Phase 5. It is a simple delivery mission from a derelict to the pyro jump point to supply the CDF for the pending fight with Xenothreat, and I heard a lot of rumbles about here how weird it was to move three boxes, but I think we actually, if we had the freight elevators, we could see kind of a true community goal of supplying the fight of, you know, hundreds, if not thousands of SCUs of things like ammunition. And it would make so much more sense and probably be the best phase so far. You could tell my bias on cargo stuff there, but on top of that, it was nearly impossible to get the mission to the point where they are trying to fix it and delay the completion of the phase so everyone has a chance to get it. Lastly, they are doing a referral reward for AP52. So anyone who signs up using your code during the event until May 2nd, you get a ship as well as your friend. All right, for the month of report, this month was an interesting one since we're now able to talk about our experiences in the earliest patches. So most of the material here, which would normally give details to what was in those patches, well, we've been talking about that stuff for weeks when we normally wouldn't be able to. So I'm going to be a bit more selective this month on what I pick out to share with you with just the things we haven't really heard about. And we're going to start out with ship art. They're almost done with the Zeus from the art perspective. And I'm sort of curious, do you guys think the pace of ship development has sped up? I mean, the Zeus is not a small ship. We know the teams got larger. A quick note, though, the Polaris was not mentioned here at all, which seemed like it was super far along. I'm sure we'll see some stuff on Invictus about that and the Zeus. They were being built in tandem with each other. So let me know, does it feel like things are happening faster? We really haven't had our first big sale since CitizenCon of things that we kind of knew that they were really working on. So yeah, let me know down below what you guys think about that. And then a bit of a surprise. The Legionnaire was mentioned, and it's already in White Box complete. If you don't know the ship, it is a boarding ship and a hacking ship together with those as a focus. And yeah, look at the way it boards. I think over 90% of the ships in game do not have proper docking collars like this. So does anyone expect hacking to make it in either? Like, I love to see them get ships done that people paid for. But man, is it disappointing when they come in with none of their gameplay. So I'm crossing my fingers here that we get a bigger surprise that the content for the ship is also in the works. Then for core gameplay, I think the biggest mention here of the entire report is that they're working on, not just talking about, or maybe it's just talking about, I don't know, but I'm not sure I care. Because whatever's going on, I love hearing that they're working on base building. Everyone here knows my enthusiasm for the connection in MMOs and survival games around things like resource extraction, crafting, and base building all together. Anytime they mention this, I'm hyped. They also mentioned a cool little UI thing with the loot screens. Basically what they mentioned on ISC about making them more designed specifically for the PU, and then engineering is up next. They mentioned something about emissions and radar, which is kind of cool, but the hull penetration is properly in as well, and life support with the room system is also being worked on. Get subscribed. As the experimental mode stabilizes a bit, I will be making a proper guide for it. Arena Commander, this is up next, and it's a nice little change with multi-crew stuff where you can prevent non-party members from joining your ship. They also dealt with the balance logic where they attempt to keep you in a squad of your friends, but also have balance in mind when it gets really out of whack. Economy. There's finally a lot to talk about here. Waiting to see action, though, man. But I love everything that I'm reading, especially the mission rewards being based on time and difficulty. These guys seem to have their heads on everything, or their hands in everything, I should say. The last sentence was music to my ears, though. Sinks. We need them so bad. I can't wait to see what these guys do. So far, not really seeing much in 323, so it might be a beyond thing, but I am looking forward to it. Then for mission design, there's a lot more here than this, but this was the meat for me. Again, my bias. Hauling missions are described very deeply in comparison to anything we've heard for years. You don't own the goods that you're hauling, and you get a payout based on which commodity you're hauling. I would love to see maybe some, I guess, modifiers to this, which would be like if the routes are more dangerous, you get paid more, things like that. But obviously, for an initial thing, this is great. And you can't just go and sell it yourself to the commodity kiosks. You will lose money if you do that. But it's still worth pirating, it seems. Really hope we see these in 323. And that's all we have for the monthly report. Again, let me know how you feel about me taking a smaller approach to the monthly report. Not everybody follows all the content, so leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think, and let's move on to video updates. All right, bit of a slow week for videos. This episode of ISC was titled Initiative Indicative, and yeah, it was all about the Overdrive Initiative event, which at this point most people have experienced almost in its entirety. So yeah, it's towards the end of the show that they kind of tip us off on some Xeno threat changes that they're making.
And now for phase six, Xeno threat, which you've all played, but we've made changes to it. We have updated the size of some of the boxes, so they're a bit more difficult to handle. You have to be more aware. Some of them will require a dedicated tractor beam. There's a new commodity that will help you out within inside phase two of Xeno threat, which is the protect and resupply of the javelin. And then the showdown has had a whole rework based on some feedback and some cool thoughts we had from the Capture the Idris event that we did. I'm not going to spoil any more of that, but stay tuned. Try to board it.
So yeah, this is all in testing right now on the PTU. The Idris has some really cool graffiti and stuff on the inside, and even cooler, the map on the inside works really well. So if you want to get to the cockpit, you just click the cockpit and it gives you the route on how to get there, and navigating around that ship gets so much easier. But again, the show was dedicated to something mostly we've experienced already, so link to the ISC is in the description if you want to watch it in its entirety. Now, there was no SCL this week, and we don't know why, but we got some good news here towards the end of the week, where hopefully the SCL will be on the 19th, and they have rescheduled it for the cargo question and answer section. So fingers crossed, it's, well, that content is in the game by then, and maybe we have more better questions we can ask in like the live stream, or we get some bad news and we find out that it might be in a .1 or the next major patch or something like that. I feel like we're going to know where cargo stands on Friday. So looking forward to that. That's all we have this week for video updates. So let's jump in to other updates. All right, real short, we're going to start out with a sneak peek. It is not much of a sneak peek at all, as they've been showing these now for a few weeks. But I think the most valuable thing you could take from this is possibly the biome they're in. Looks like Microtech around one of the settlements. Then we just had a lore post, and it's a simple lore post about the Vulture and its history. And it's basically your typical article from Jump Point that they're pulling out and repurposing as a thing that is like new or whatever, which is not. So that is really all we have this week, guys. I want to say this week was really frustrating. Again, I'm super nervous. I always make this mistake. I get super excited for something that's going to happen in Star Citizen, and it never quite happens the way you envision it, right? I think same goes for CIG and the way they think things are going to happen, because they communicate it a certain way and then it doesn't really work out that way, right? It just is what it is. But at the same time, I am kind of bummed out. I was really, really looking forward to the hangar stuff, and I'm really starting to feel like we just might not. If you guys caught the Answer the Call podcast, this week, me and Kronzi made a little bit of a bet. If it gets into the .0 patch, he has to be a character of my choice that I get to make, and the opposite if it does make it in. So, we'll see. I'm really starting to feel not excited, but there's some cool stuff. I might just spend my entire time playing Gun Rush with, you know, experiencing the FPS weapons and engineering or something, right? There are things to engage with, especially learning master modes and all that stuff, right? So there's tons of stuff to engage with. I just have to focus on the things that maybe I wasn't super excited about. So let me know how you guys feel about the way things are going right now. Obviously, we're still just in wave one. Almost none of you have access to the build. And this is a little bit doom and gloomy where maybe we shouldn't be. We're a few weeks away from Invictus, but I don't know how early they want the .0 patch out before they come out with Invictus. If we look at the history, Invictus is a .1 patch. At least it was last year. So we'll have to see what the plans are from them and how quickly they push things out. But that's all I got for you guys this week, and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next week in review. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment, all that stuff, and let me know if I missed anything, because it was very hard for me to get into the game this week, so I'm going to need those comments down below to keep me updated on Star Citizen. So thank you again for watching. Thank you for all the love recently, and I look forward to a better week, I hope, and we'll see.